You look well. Word of our growing settlement has reached outside ears, so have a look around. You may see a few new faces.
We are allied with the Danes of Grandabritshire. Their Jarlskonna, Soma, has pledged an oath.
Well done, Eivor. These early victories will pay off well.
They will. In more than one way, one of Soma's finest fighters, Birna, has pledged her blade to us. She's a powerful fighter, and a charming spirit. I think she'll fit in nicely.
Glad to have her. Good work. Eivor, a word of note. Someone has set up shop outside. A trader, I believe. When you can, ask him his business here. He seems to represent a larger guild. The Child's Eyes, or the Eyeless Children?
Eyeless Children?
No, that cannot be right. Ask him yourself.
I want to see the Alliance map. Tell me more about Leda Chestershire. I should like to join Sigurd soon.
He traveled to a town called Repton to meet Uba and Ivar Ragnarsson. As I hear it, they are on the verge of exiling the current King of Mercia, with the hope of installing a king of their own.
A bold endeavor. I should be there to help, however I can.
I think you should.
I won't keep them waiting.
Good. I will send word to Sigurd and the Ragnarssons, pledging your assistance. If I were you, I would go by ship. Repton is quite a distance north on the River Trent.
Can you remind me what you do here?
When you hunt any animal, bring it here for a trade, and if you get something really special, I'm happy to mount it. That said, though, I can't do much until you build me a place to work. It won't do tanning hides on makeshift tables and dirt.
I must take my leave. So long.
Happy hunting!
Birna, welcome to the Raven Clan's nest.
Good to be here, Sunbeam. The people here seem a mixed bag of nuts and seeds. I feel right at home.
You are at home. Settle in and get a feel for the place. We will be heading out soon enough.
Of course. A quick drink and a friendly brawl, and I will be ready for the raids ahead.
Thank you for this. Whether fur, meat, or bone, we will provide only the finest.
And if you intend to go hunting, consider bringing us your kills. We will prepare the hides and heads.
Aye. I've been mounting Petra's trophies for years, and she's a discerning woman.
In all things.
I'll keep that in mind. Enjoy your new home.
Eivor, you seem to be someone with a penchant for trophies.
I do like victories, but I rarely keep a record of them.
Your weapons show the marks of great battles, and you walk with a pride that speaks to your triumphs. Am I wrong?
You are not. Why do you ask?
To bolster our trade, of course. Wallace is the finest tanner and taxidermist in all of England. If you wish the tales of your hunts to outlast you, there is no better way than making trophies of your kills. If you defeat a rare and worthy creature, bring it to us. We will display it for you.
A good idea. Keepsakes to adorn the longhouse. Thank you, Petra.
Oh, and before you go, could you spare a moment for a small favor?
Go ahead.
For the past few evenings, I've heard the howling of a pack of wolves just beyond the border of our woods. Unchecked, they will ravage the wild game in this area, and once the deer are dead, they may turn to us.
You feel we should drive them off?
I would eliminate them entirely, with your permission, of course, and your help, if possible.
A good idea. I will join you now.
Good. A pack of wolves is a foolish thing to underestimate. Let's go.
This way. I last saw them prowling around just up the hill.
You lead. I'll follow.
Our settlement is in quite a nice spot. Beautiful terrain, and the animals here are healthy and populous. But wolves are a worry. It may be why the Ragnarssons moved on. Humans upset the balance of nature, and nature pushed back.
By attacking us.
A wolf will do whatever it takes. They were displaced. Now they come to our door. Come this way. Look here. Breadcrumbs and crusts. They must have stolen something from Tarbin's stall, or off a table somewhere.
You saw breadcrumbs from where you stood.
They stand out clearly from the soil and grass. See there? Come. This way. Ah, smell that. That's a male wolf, marking his territory, warding off the competition.
How do you know it's a male?
A different odor. You pick it up.
How did you come to be such a skilled tracker?
My family were hunters and trackers, from further east than you've ever seen, I imagine. But I've lived in England for most of my life. This is where we found Wallace.
You two are siblings, as Sigurd and I are siblings. Bound by honor, not blood.
Yes. To hear my mother tell it, we came upon Wallace abandoned, a babe in the woods. We took him in. Look. The wolves made a kill here. They're in the area. Those trails. They must have dragged the poor beast away. We're getting closer. Ah, see those teeth marks on the carcass? They're different.
This is the pack's doing, not just one.
That's right. Let's go on.
So your family found Wallace in the woods?
We were traveling through the forest when I spotted a white elk ahead of us. I chased it, hoping to take it down. I lost it as I came to a clearing. And there on the ground was a wee babe, our little Wallace, swaddled and alone. Ah, look at that, the pattern on the grass. They slept here.
I'm impressed, Petra. You have a raw skill.
You have seen nothing just yet.
So you saw a white elk, and that led you to Wallace.
That's right. It felt fated. We took him in and nursed him back to health. I was scarcely more than a toddler myself then. And from that day forward, we were raised as brother and sister. These kills are fresh. They're likely near enough to hear us. Probably fled the scene not long ago.
Ah! Help!
I think we found our wolves.
You there! Get to cover. Eivor, with me. Let's end this.
I'm at your side.
Thank you.
There. That should be all of them.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much, both of you.
Are you all right? Were those your sheep?
They were. God take them. They were all I had in the world. Poor blighters never stood a chance. I lost my cows some months back. Now the sheep are gone. Frowning Jesus, what sort of farmer am I?
I'm sorry for your loss. With the wolves gone, you can recover in peace.
Not without the blessings of God, I won't. But I shall try.
You have your life, farmer. With that alone, you can always rebuild.
Eivor, hold. I hear something.
What? I don't hear any... Oh! Oh, goodness gracious me! Felix! Rosemary! My beauties! You're alive! Come here, my precious angels!
Well, that worked out.
This is grand, Eivor. You hunt almost as well as you fight.
Give me a few weeks, I'll learn to track as well as you. Or better.
I would be happy to be so humbled.
This was a joy, Petra. Do not hesitate to call on me the next time you spot any errant beasts.
You were the first on my list, Eivor. See you soon.
Bex, are you seeing this?
Yeah, it's weird. An anomaly of some kind. The rest of your simulation is frozen.
I can see a loose data packet close by. I'll see if I could reach it.
Okay, but take it slow. We don't know what this thing is.
Wake, my love, wake! Soldiers at our door, they've come for you, for us.
Let them take me, I have no more fear. Let me air my wrath in the courts.
They'll kill you before they let you speak.
I'll appeal to the council. They must know what the mad one has done.
They're upon us. Now is not the time.
Huh.
Bex. I'm closing in on the data packet.
I see it. It's encrypted, but nothing I can't handle.
Got it.
Good day. A new customer.
Whether I am or not, I am the one you'll speak with. Randri tells me you are merchants.
Ah, hello, hello. Are you the leader of this bustling encampment? We come on behalf of a Thousand Eyes, vendors of uncommon goods and exotic treasures from all corners of the world. If you need it, we have it. If we don't have it, you don't need it. Such is our pledge.
I see. And is this child with you?
Child?
Child?
My friend, you look upon the Master of the Thousand Eyes, the head of our guild. A legend, a hero of the people, and the richest merchant west of the Indus, you look upon Redda!
He means you?
He does, Eivor Wolfkist. It is a pleasure to meet you at last.
How have you come to know me?
The Thousand Eyes have 1,000 years as well, and word travels fast.
And what is it I can do for you, or you for me?
It's quite simple. For a fee, I can connect you to a shadow market that stretches from the dunes of Egypt to the moors of England.
What sort of fee?
It varies with the item, but there is a small hitch. Through this market, all prices are paid in opal.
A striking color. Is it rare?
Rarer than an honest man in England. You must keep your eyes open for this mineral. It has great value. Now look here. Browse what wares I have on offer. Excellent choice, and a lucky one too, for nothing in stock lingers very long. My selection changes daily. Now that you are friends with me, you are also a friend of the Thousand Eyes as well.
And what does this mean?
Observe my outfit, not the scarf I wear. As you travel, you will meet many of my associates clad in these same vestments. These are my people, my other eyes. Seek them out for trade or contracts. Oblige them, and you will earn a tidy sum. And I might even feel inclined to reward you myself.
An interesting offer.
Good to hear. Now, if you'll excuse us, my apprentice has a tent to secure.
You're staying for a while, I suppose.
Oh, yes, and you needn't even thank me. We would be honored to call this our home. Good day.